Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the topic transportation. So transportation, as all life processes, transportation is one of the life process which takes place in both animals and plants as well. So first we will discuss about the transportation in human beings. The main transport system in human beings is circulatory system. It consists of blood, arteries, veins, capillaries and heart. So first is blood. Blood transports food, oxygen and waste products. It consists of plasma, red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets. Plasma transports food, water, carbon dioxide, nitrogenous waste, etc. Red blood cells transport oxygen. White blood cells kills harmful microbes and protects the body. Platelets helps in clotting of blood and prevent loss of blood during injury. Now next is arteries. Arteries carry pure blood, that is oxygenated blood, from heart to all parts of body. They are thick-walled and do not have walls. Veins carry impure blood, that is the deoxygenated blood, from all parts of body to the heart. They are thin-walled and have walls. Capillaries are very narrow blood vessels which connects arteries and veins together. The exchange of food, water, oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. between the blood and cells takes place through the capillaries. Heart. Now, heart is a muscular organ which pumps blood to all parts of body. It has four chambers. The upper chamber are called atria and the lower chambers are called ventricles. Since the ventricles pump blood to the different organ, its walls are thicker than atria or atrium. The right and left chambers are separated by a septum. SAQ, it prevents the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. The atria and ventricle have valves between them to prevent blood flowing forward. Now we will talk about the working of heart. When the left atrium relaxes, oxygenated blood from lungs flows into it through the pulmonary vein. Yaad rakhna bache, pulmonary vein jo hai oxygenated blood carry kar rahi hai, lekin pulmonary artery deoxygenated blood carry hai. Rest all arteries oxygenated blood carry karti hain, rest all veins deoxygenated blood carry karti hain. Sirf pulmonary wali exceptional case hai. So when the left atrium relaxes, oxygenated blood from the lungs flows into it through the pulmonary vein. When it contracts, the left ventricle expands and the blood flows into it. Then the left ventricle contracts and the oxygenated blood is pumped out through the aorta to all parts of body. After circulating through all parts of body, the deoxygenated bloods enter the right atrium through the vena cava. There are two types of vena cava. Matlab एक अपर वीना कावा होता है, लोअर वीना कावा. अपर वीना कावा कलेक्ट करता है ब्लड अपर बॉडी पार्ट से एंड लोअर वीना कावा लोअर बॉडी पार्ट से. व्हेन द राइट एट्रियम कंट्रैक्ट द राइट वेंट्रिकल एक्सपैंड एंड द ब्लड फ्लोज इनटू इट. देन द राइट वेंट्रिकल कंट्रैक्ट एंड द ब्लड इज पम्प्ड टू द लंग्स थ्रू द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. In the lungs, carbon dioxide is removed and oxygen is absorbed. And the oxygenated blood again enters the left atrium and the process repeats. Since blood flows through the heart twice in one cycle, it is called the double circulation. Now talking about lymph. Lymph is a colorless fluid present in intercellular spaces. It is formed from plasma which escapes from the capillaries. Lymph drains into the lymphatic capillaries which forms lymph vessel and joints into the large veins. Lymph transports digested fats and drains excess fluid from intercellular spaces back into the blood. It contains lymphocytes, which kills germs and protects the body. Now, in your syllabus, heart of mammal, bird, amphibian, reptiles, fishes are there. So, you have to just go through the brief about them. So, heart of mammal. Mammal includes all advanced organisms like human being. The heart in mammals and birds have four chambers, and right and left sides of heart is separated by a septum. This prevents the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood and provides efficient supply of oxygen. This is necessary because they need more energy to maintain their body temperature. The heart in amphibians and reptiles have three chambers and allows some mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood because they do not use energy to maintain their body temperature. Their body temperature is same as the temperature of surroundings. The heart in fishes have only two chambers and blood is oxygenated in the gills. So this was about the transport in human beings.